It sure is beautiful. I can't imagine anybody wanting to use this, though. I mean, like, how can you? I can't bring myself to do it. But maybe you would after you make your very own razor after watching today's episode.
Welcome back to Matt's Basement Workshop. Sponsored by
MicroJig, maker of the Gripper. Work safer, work smarter.
Hey everybody, welcome back to Matt's Basement Workshop. So on today's episode, it is the end of November, which means Movember or No Shave November is starting to wind down right now. And as I had mentioned in the beard comb video from earlier this month, this is a time of year, this whole Movember movement is a opportunity for people to say maybe grow out a mustache or maybe a beard to help raise awareness for some really important health issues such as prostate or testicular cancer or other issues that oftentimes are associated with men. Hopefully, if you are one of those individuals who grew out the facial hair, you're doing it to raise money that you will donate to a charity that will help to fund research to find a cure for these really horrible diseases. Now, myself, quite obviously, I've had this for quite a while. So rather than donating money to me from other individuals or something, I've got a friend who grew out some facial hair just for this, so I'm gonna donate money to him. To now wrap up the month, I know many of you are going to go right back to that clean, close-shaved face that you have. I don't know why. This is great in the winter. And that's why today's episode is going to be this really awesome razor that we have here. Now, this particular one is made from some really beautiful tulip wood that I had laying around. In fact, I've got a couple other projects to go along with this that my patrons will be seeing. But for today's episode, we're going to turn this really awesome razor kit. Now, it was really, really super simple. In fact, literally just this kit alone, if I had made the more cylindrical body, which you see on a lot of them, basically it looks like a long piece of dowel. If I had done that, I probably could have knocked this out maybe in half an hour. It probably took more time to drill the hole for the insert that's going in here than anything else. So it's a neat project, something that you could probably batch several of these out and give them to loved ones, maybe for the holidays or something, since those are just around the corner. But it's a lot of fun. Now, just to let you know, again, I made it from some really gorgeous tulip wood that I had, and this is the actual blank that I started with. What I ended up doing is I kind of cut it down to size. You can kind of see here that I ended up cutting it out of this so that it was less turning that I had to do. But this is more or less the size of material that you're going to need for this project. In fact, one of the instructions recommends that you cut the blank down to about the length of the insert just to make it that much easier. So anyways, let's go ahead and jump right into the episode. Again, a lot of fun. Maybe I'll batch out a few more of these. Like I said, they're a fantastic holiday gift. But anyway, so let's go ahead and jump right into the episode and see how much fun this was.
So the first step is to drill the required 7mm diameter hole for the included tube insert. And of course, I didn't have a 7mm drill bit, but this 9/32 inch drill bit is going to work out perfectly fine. Now, obviously, I should have cleared the bit a little more frequently, as at the end here, the piece obviously heats up and smoke starts coming out when the bit bore through the bottom end. Or this could essentially be called like the barbecue option for my drill press. It's maybe a little off center, but it's drilled, and once we put it on the lathe, it will be centered perfectly fine. Now, the next step is that we need to glue the tube into the hole. To ensure good adhesion, I'll rough up the surface of the tube with some sandpaper. And when it's good and scratched up, I'll apply some CA glue to the end of the tube, then insert it into the hole. Now, by applying it at one end, as the tube slides in, the glue is going to be dispersed along the entire length without having to worry about it pooling up at one end or another. So now with the insert glued into place, let's head out to the lathe where we're going to set it up on our pen mandrel. So then after a couple of quick adjustments to the tool rest, a spin or two to assure it's in the right position, it's now time to start roughing the blank with a roughing gouge. Now obviously I'm editing the footage for time, and it really honestly didn't take more than a few minutes to turn the blank almost completely round. Well, except for, of course, this one flat face, but a couple more minutes with the roughing gouge and it's history. Then it's time for a quick test to see how it feels in the hand, and it's now time to start shaping the handle, specifically bringing the two ends down to the required 3/4 inch diameter for the end caps. For this task, we'll just simply grab the spindle gouge and we'll start to slowly work the shape, working from the center out. In other words, going from high to low eventually. Again, after only a few minutes in unedited time, I'm close to the final dimension for this first end. A few more passes, and it's now time to start turning our attention to the opposite end. So several minutes later, it's time to start blending together all those curves and checking for the final dimensions. To be sure that we're done shaping, we'll take the blank off the mandrel and insert the decorative end cap for sizing. If you were a patron of Matt's Basement Workshop at patreon.com for as little as $2 per month, you'd have seen this episode before it was released to the public. And starting at $5 a month, you'll get bonus footage from every episode. This time around, it's the creation of this beautiful matching razor stand. At $15 a month, you get an entire episode, not available anywhere else. For the month of November, it's the creation of this beautiful turned shaving brush, also from Tulip Wood. And regardless of what level of patronage you choose, each month you're eligible for great swag giveaways. For more information, visit patreon.com/mattsbasementworkshop. And we're back to the show. And with the blank back on the mandrel, it's now time to start sanding. First, with a little 150 grit to help remove the tool marks. Then it's on to 240 grit to further refine the surface. Then some 320, followed by 450, and then it's all topped off with something like a 620 grit. The final step is then grabbing some shavings and burnishing the surface. Now before I apply the finish, I'm going to take some paper towel, not a rag, as all of you have informed me, not the right thing to do, and I'm going to clean the surface and remove traces from the abrasives. Then, it's simply time to apply the friction finish, a nice shellac mixture that will leave a tough but beautiful finish. A liberal amount applied to the surface, then once it's thoroughly covered, I work it into a fine luster with a little pressure and slight buffing action. Next, it's back into the shop to assemble those end caps, and they fit rather snug into the tube that's glued into the blank, so it may need a little persuasion to get them in place. Now, with the bottom end cap in place, I'm going to do the same thing to the top, and then it's time to screw the razor head in position. The result? It's a rather gorgeous-looking razor for those who prefer a rather more naked kind of face.
All right, folks, and that is really seriously all there is to making this great little razor kit. I'm going to have links in the show notes for everybody if you want to go ahead and order these, say, like at Woodcraft. That's probably where I'll end up having this. If you have a Woodcraft nearby, you can find these there in the pen turning section. If you have a retailer that sells pen turning kits, there's a very good chance that they'll probably have something like this available there. You can definitely play with the size of this. You can play, you know, with the length, probably maybe get a longer insert and make it just a little bit longer. Maybe you've got much bigger, beefier hands or something that you want something really unique to play with. Fun opportunity to play with some scrap wood or maybe some exotics that you've always wanted to try. You see those in the bargain bins or something. But regardless of what you do, like I said, you can batch out a whole bunch of these probably in a single weekend, and it's a really great holiday gift to give to somebody, or maybe a birthday, or just if you want to tell somebody that they're pretty special and they need to shave, this might be a really great way to do it. So if you have comments, questions, suggestions, you can email me at mattsbasementworkshop@gmail.com. You can leave a comment in the show notes, of course, where you're going to find the links for this, over at mattsbasementworkshop.com. And of course, if you're watching this on YouTube, you can leave a comment over there. So again, I don't know why anybody really wants to kind of take a razor to the face. It seems kind of dangerous. It's probably better to have a full beard, especially now that winter is here, but that's just me. So until the next time, straight grains and sharp blades. Take care, everybody.
Thanks for watching. For more information on topics discussed in this episode, visit mattsbasementworkshop.com. Also, please consider becoming a patron of Matt's Basement Workshop. Get early access to new shows, bonus content from each episode, and so much more. Visit patreon.com/mattsbasementworkshop to sign up and start receiving your benefits today.